The final chapter of the Purge series is heading to theaters this summer, but in the movie itself, it seems the Purge may never end. Here's everything you need to know about the fifth Purge movie, The Forever Purge. If you've been following the Purge franchise over the years, you know that hell truly is other people, especially if you're out past dark on a Purge night. Set in a dystopian alternate version of the United States, led by the new founding fathers of America, the series focuses on a violent yearly event in which all crime is declared legal for 12 hours, up to and including mass murder. The Forever Purge was conceived by James DeMonaco, creator of the Purge franchise, who told Entertainment Weekly in 2018 he had a really cool notion for the series' next installment, which he predicted would be the series' final chapter. The movie entered into development at Universal Pictures in May of 2019, according to Deadline, at which time it was originally scheduled for release on July 10, 2020. DeMonaco wrote the screenplay, with Everardo Goot signing on to direct the film. As a filmmaker, Goot has mainly made a name for himself in television, with credits on series like Netflix's Luke Cage and AMC's The Terror. But what drew Universal's eyes to Goot, according to Variety, was his work on National Geographic's Mars miniseries, which combined scripted drama with documentary footage and interviews with actual scientists. The Forever Purge was shot in various locations in California from November 2019 to February 2020, according to The Hollywood Reporter. While the COVID-19 pandemic didn't impact the production of The Forever Purge, it did delay the movie's release, which was moved from 2020 to July 2, 2021, and reports indicate that The Forever Purge really is the franchise's final installment.
The annual purge will conclude in 3, 2, 1.
Like the first Purge before it, The Forever Purge will plunge a whole new set of people into the franchise's typical stew of mayhem, violence, and anarchy. The characters will likely fall into the mold of the series' other heroes and heroines. They will be vulnerable, likable, relatable, and tough, but not superheroes. The movie's lead actors, Ana de la Reguera and Tinoch Huerta, will head the cast, with support from Will Patton, Casti Freeman, Josh Lucas, and more. According to the movie's logline, The Forever Purge focuses on a couple named Adela and Juan. After fleeing a drug cartel in Mexico, they take up a peaceful life on a Texas ranch. Unfortunately, they've unwittingly walked into a world of trouble as a group of angry locals have decided that they're going to take the law into their own hands and extend the typical 12-hour purge curfew beyond its time limit. Cue anarchy.
How's that feel?
It's the real purge.
The Forever Purge!
Adela, Juan, and their newfound friends team up to drive the outsiders away and restore order, or at least flee to safety and freedom across the border in Mexico. In a lot of ways, The Forever Purge sounds like another opportunity for the series to explore themes of class warfare, vigilantism, and racial tensions and solidarity, all of which this series has previously explored to great effect. Speaking to Total Film in a January interview, director Everardo Goot described the movie as an amazing story of Latinos and Americans coming together to overcome despair and evil. Writer James DeMonaco hopes to set the record straight with this final edition of the franchise, aiming to clarify the moral of the story once and for all. From the sound of things, the movie has no sympathy for the chaos-seeking purgers. Goot broke down the intentions behind DeMonaco's script in his interview with Total Film, saying, "DeMonaco told me I want my intentions to be crystal clear on what I think about violence and what's going on in the world. It's dystopian, but he's trying to get us to look in the mirror." And like all Purge movies, part of the point is to make the audience consider what they would do if they ended up in the character's shoes. The Purge franchise's timeline is relatively straightforward. The first Purge is a prequel to The Purge, which is followed by Anarchy, and then Election Year in the timeline. USA's two-season-long The Purge TV show takes place between Anarchy and Election Year. The Forever Purge fittingly takes place after The Purge Election Year. since election year, sets up a future in which the purge stands a strong chance of being done away with by the incoming president. The story so far is potentially at a perfect starting point for a renegade forever purge. Plot-wise, the series has always taken the form of an anthology, which gives the viewer a look at how different social classes react to the stressful hellscape that is the purge. There have only been two characters who have crossed over between editions of the franchise. Those characters are Edwin Hodges' Dwayne, aka The Stranger, who appears in The Purge Anarchy, and The Purge Election Year, and Frank Grillo's Leo Barnes, aka The Sergeant, who appears in Anarchy and Election Year. Another constant across all iterations of the franchise is Cindy Robinson, who voices the public announcements that declare The Purge's ending and beginning. Robinson can in fact be heard in the trailer for The Forever Purge.
I'm not telling them to go out and kill people, right?
You're just stating the rules.
The Forever Purge will be released theatrically, with no announced plans for a simultaneous streaming release. It will be replacing Universal's previous pick for their July 4th weekend release, Top Gun: Maverick, which has had its own release date shuffled over to November 19th. There's actually a reason why you probably won't be seeing the film on the small screen as soon as you may like. As reported by Deadline, Universal Pictures recently struck a deal with theater chains Cineworld in the UK and Regal Cinemas in the US for a new post-pandemic mutually agreed-upon theatrical window. According to that agreement, Regal Cinemas will have a 31-day exclusivity window on movies that open at above $50 million, and a 17-day exclusivity agreement for movies opening below that threshold. Cineworld will have a 31-day window prior to any sort of pay-on-demand service, extending to 45 days for any movie that opens at an agreed-upon box office milestone. What that means is that you won't be seeing The Forever Purge on demand for at least 31 days after its release. You will likely have to wait even longer for other streaming platforms to offer the movie if it happens to make a lot of money at the box office. Essentially, movie theaters want you back, and The Forever Purge is part of the plan.
Thank you for your participation.
No matter how long they have to wait to see the film's final installment, Purge fans will hopefully feel that The Forever Purge serves as a fitting final hurrah for one of the most interesting, bankable franchises in the modern horror canon. Check out one of our newest videos right here! Plus, even more Looper videos about The Purge and other horror movies are coming soon. Subscribe to our YouTube channel and hit the bell so you don't miss a single one.